Today we're checking the Darkglass Alpha Omicron, a small but very powerful distortion pedal for those who don't want to mess around with just a little bit of extra gain. This thing is brutal and I would say, let's get started. This is Craig from Bassable.com and today I have the pleasure to walk you through the Darkglass Alpha Omicron pedal, which is the bitey little brother, well actually a sister, I can't really tell, of the Alpha Omega, which came out last year and kinda set a new standard for all the bassists to like it brutal and rough and dirty. What? No. I'm still talking about distortion pedals. Boring. The whole idea behind the Alpha Omega concept, or also the Alpha Omicron of course, is the combination of two different distortion circuits. We have the Alpha and the Omega side. Here on this knob we have the Alpha on the left, which is a rather tight and punchy sound, which sounds a little bit compressed and very nice for rock stuff. And when we go over to the Omega side, it gets more rough and brutal, and yeah, it definitely has a lot more highs. And with this mod knob you can combine and blend these two together to create a whole lot of different distortion sounds. Short interruption from future video editing Gregor, that would be me. The video is finished, the guys from Darkglass have seen it already, they like it, I guess and hope. And they said there's one thing that could have been mentioned if this was actually a proper and decent bass channel. The Alpha Omega and also the Alpha Omicron both can be used with a lot less gain than the Microtubes pedals actually, even if they are mainly made for high gain stuff. Which is interesting, and I think you could hear that in the last sample, and yeah, this... Now it's mentioned. Let's go on. In addition to the mod, we have a drive control, which sets the gain for the distortion. Blend mixes the mayhem with your clean tone, which always stays at unigain. The volume of the distorted sound is controlled separately by the level knob. And we have these two little knobs here, which is by the way a brilliant little thing at Darkglass. I definitely prefer them over the mini toggle switches all previous pedals used to have. Bite boosts your hi-hats for some more presence and definition, and Growl adds a lot of fat by boosting lows that give you even more saturation. I've played all the Darkglass pedals they've ever made except for two. One is the compressor that they made in the very early days before they took over and became this huge, very successful and probably most popular distortion pedal brand on the market. And the other pedal is the Alpha Omega, which is really sad. So I know a thing or two about these pedals, and let me tell you, they just keep getting better. I'm fascinated by this company. This is now definitely my favorite pedal for all kind of dirty high gain noise thingies, and yeah, I just love it. In case you're wondering if you should rather go with the Alpha Omega or the Alpha Omicron, let me give you some pros and cons for each pedal. First of all, the Alpha Omicron is smaller, which is really cool because it means at the end on your pedal board there will be more space for other pedals, which is good. Also, the Alpha Omicron is a lot more affordable, which definitely is a big deal. On the other hand, the Alpha Omega, of course, it's more expensive, it's bigger, but it has a lot more controls. In addition to everything you have here, you have a 3-band EQ, basses, mids and treble, which is especially nice for those who like to tweak their sound to perfection and find a sweet spot for everything. This is definitely cool, but I have to say, I like how this pedal sounds and I think you can use it right away. I don't feel that there needs to be a lot more control. So for me, this is really enough, I have to say. Others might value these things a little bit different, but I think this is actually really cool. The Alpha Omega also has an DI out, which is cool, and it has a parallel out, so a second, so you can go to a second amp with a clean sound or something like this. This is kind of cool, but I would say I don't really need it, because if I want to have some parallel processing for these sounds, well, there's a blend knob here, which basically does the same. Of course, in the studio, it's nice if you have two separate channels and signal paths, but well, there are other devices where you can achieve the same thing if you really need it. It's nice to have it in the pedal, but not really necessary. Alpha Omega is definitely more professional because there's a lot more you can do with the sound tweaking with the EQ, but on the other hand, I think this is pretty much enough. Both pedals are based on the same circuit, so they basically sound the same. So if you like the Alpha Omega, but you think you can't afford it, you will be absolutely fine with this one. Yeah, these are just my two cents. Some other players might value these pedals a little bit different, but yeah, that's just my opinion. If you have any questions or some advice or whatever, feel free to leave it in the comment section below. I will gladly get back to you. And otherwise, that's it for today. See you next time. Bye.